right, so the first piece we're gonna start with are the side panels, which seem like they're gonna be really intimidating, but you guys, I promise you, it'll all be okay. It's gonna work out. Just kind of sorting through my pile of interfaced items. I guess I could talk about how I interface them. So for the main flap, I've cut out, this has Decoville Light or 809. This has two pieces of Decoville Light where I'm gonna add that snap. The bottom has one layer of Decoville Heavy and then a Frankenstein piece of Decoville Light over top. For the side panels, I used fleece, and what I do is I just cut out an extra piece, a pattern piece, and cut it down to the foam or fleece, whatever. But I used fusible fleece for those. I've got those. And then I used woven fuse and Decoville Light for these side panels because I like them to have a little more structure, a little more body. I don't want them to wrinkle over time. So that's how I do that. And once I get done with those side panels, I'm gonna make my shoulder straps, and I'm adding a crossbody strap to this bag, but I wanna make sure we can make those first, since, you know, you don't wanna run out of bobbin thread. So I am using these 7-inch zippers. These are from Zipper Island. Zip It on Etsy. I think it's Zip It on Etsy. But they're really, really cute. They've got a little donut pull so you can add a charm or something to it. But anyway, so we're gonna grab one of these panels. And so lay center side panel, right side up, pin just the closed end of a 7-inch zipper so that the metal zip is 5/8 of an inch from the bottom short end. Okay, let me just be extra. 3, 4, 5, yeah, that's what I thought. Okay, so basically that's like the very end of the zipper tape. Like. Now you're going to open the zipper the entire way and pin or glue base just along the raw edge. And I'm just going to use these clips here and just clip them slowly along that. And then we're going to turn this side of our zipper under. So there's what that looks like. It's been turned under. So just whoosh in your fingers. This bag is actually one of the first handbags that I made. Well, I guess Charlotte was by Swoon, but this one was like one of the more complicated ones. Oh, hi Ben. How's it going? You gonna help me? And it's just a really fun and unique pattern. And learning this technique was super fun. I'd never made a bag that could close and zip on one side, though it's not the most practical, I guess. I don't know. So I'm just slowly basting the zipper in place. You don't want to sew too close. And then I'm just going to go down one side and up the other. That. And you really don't need to clip your thread at the moment. So yeah, lining up my teeth with the other side. Just baste it along. Okay, so there is that zipper in place. You can see up top how I've curved those off at the edge. And then I'm gonna repeat the same step. And I am in love with these navy colored zippers. Nailed it. Okay. Well, that's 5/8. just gonna center it along the bottom and unzip it. And also, I ironed my zippers first. I always feel like that helps with wonkiness. If you don't like ironing your zippers before you start sewing, it's no biggie. Actually, in my sewing group, I did like a little bit of a poll to see who actually irons their zippers, and a lot of people don't. And I'm like, okay, that's cool. But I have had people say that it made a little bit of a difference, so I don't know. You tell me. Do you think ironing your zippers really works, or am I just crazy and it gives me the confidence to sew a zipper that doesn't look wonky? Okay, so there it is, all clipped in place. These hair clips I purchased from Sally Beauty. You can buy a box of 100 for like $6, I want to say. And I find these hold things in place much better than pins. And they're not always as strong as these. So if I use these to clip it in place, like each one I'd have to like pinch and pull. But these I can just slide off with my fingers as I go along. So I have a lot of questions about those and wanted to answer it in the video for you guys. So you can see, I can just sew and it slides right off. I love it. This bag I'm making is for a custom order through my Facebook group, but it's also for a friend of mine, like kind of someone else in the crafting community in my area, so I'm really excited to get it done for her. So we're not done yet, but I'm just gonna show you guys kind of what that does. So it folds that in, and then when you unzip it, it lays out flat, you know? So it's an expandable bag, and I think it's such a cool concept. I'm so excited for you guys to make this bag. Okay, with this bag, you want to make sure that you're following those seam allowances to a T. The very first time I made one, I totally messed it up. Okay, so these should be mirrored towards each other, so when you lay these pieces together, they should fit. All those curves should fit together. So you kind of just want to make little piles of your bag pieces. So what we are going to do is we're going to start at the top. These pieces have little diagonal notches, I want to call them, and you're going to start by lining those up. So we're going to start at this top corner, and those little diagonal notches should just line up perfectly. And then as you go, you want to clip and just kind of pinch it along. Because it's a curve, it's going to be a little difficult at first, but trust me, you got this. I believe in you. You can do it. And then they should line up just perfectly if you start at those notches at the top. So you'll see it's going to kind of curve to match, and that's okay. That's what you want. So we're going to start at the bottom, and we're going to follow right next to that fleece, making sure that we are not sewing through the zipper tooth. And if you have to move the zipper pull, go ahead and do that. Definitely don't want to sew through it. So I'm just going nice and slow. You can kind of feel your zipper teeth through the other side. So you want to make sure you're not sewing through those. And then when you get to the top, do a little back stitch, and you should have sewn directly across that notch. And then when you open it up, this is what it looks like. It's pretty cool. So now I'm going to switch my stitch length over to about a 4.5. And I'm gonna sew along that curve and just kind of pull it out as you go. If your zipper tape showing doesn't look even, you might wanna re-sew that seam and just try it again. Okay, So there's what that looks like. And now we're gonna sew the other piece. We're just gonna keep doing that. So we're gonna start by lining up those notches. And this, you'll kind of see this overhang on the edge, and add a clip. And then just kind of reposition as you go, add a clip. And I'm just slowly moving downward and pinching it together. Okay, so you can see it's like that. And this time I'm gonna start at the top just because it's a little bit easier for me from this angle. Move your stitch length back to a 3.5 and then just feel along the zipper teeth with your finger. And then if you have to, as you get closer, just leave your needle in and zip it back up. This might be a little difficult, but it can help. And then, of course, we have to unzip it. And then just pull that seam open. And then switch to a longer stitch length. That's what your side panel looks like. And then when you zip it up, that's what that looks like. So we're gonna unzip it. And we're gonna sew the bottom panel on. These should line up pretty perfectly. My exterior is a little bit wider. The bottom part, I should say, is a little bit wider than the top part. That's okay, just kind of center it out. Make sure it's centered. We're gonna sew along the fleece line. Make sure you don't hit that metal stop. Stitch. Snip. And then you're gonna fold it down and sew along the bottom here. So there is the side panel all finished. Again, I just think it's so fun to zip it up as you go. You'll see it just kind of take shape. And that to me is really, really cool. What you looking at, Ben? What are you doing? All right, so I'm gonna unzip this. On the other side. Okay. So starting at those top notches, that's wrong. Here we go. Starting at the top notch. You're doing a top notch job. I don't know, don't ask. So it's going to be easier to start at the bottom for this side. Okay, open it up. always like to backstitch at the beginning and the end of my top stitch. Such a sad, I love this color combination too. I'm so excited she picked this. I sent her a few different color options with this fabric and she was like, let's go ahead and do the gray. And I was like, yes. Because it's such a nice, cool, it's almost like a wintry color scheme, but really you can carry a handbag any time of the year and who cares. As I go. Okay, just kind of move my zipper pull out of the way. These line up. Again, they're not quite perfect, but that's okay. We're just gonna kind of center it and then we'll make up for it when we do the seam allowance. So it's not a big deal. Half an inch seam allowance. Make sure you don't hit that zipper stop or the pull. So right next to that fleece. Okay, so there is that side panel all finished as well. And I'm gonna set those aside. I'm gonna get started on the shoulder straps and the crossbody strap just because I like to do those first. I think it's really nice to get them out of the way, and then when you're ready to add the lining, you're pretty much done with your bag, and that is a great feeling. Let me grab my double-sided tape, which has somehow moved on me. I don't know where it is, so let me open a new one. This is double-sided tape from waywax.com. The sizes I like to use are 1/2 inch and 1/4 inch. So I buy these in excess. It's waywak.com. I just line these up on my center mark. Not all sewing machines are able to sew through the double-sided tape, so keep that in mind. Your machine may not like it. But luckily, I've been using mine for, I don't know, like 2 years at this point, and we're still okay. I'm gonna start with the side straps, or the shoulder straps, because I think I'll be running out of bobbin soon. This is not a fresh bobbin, so we'll see. So fold the edges of your handles into the center line. I make my center line by cutting my handle to 4 inches wide, and then I make a line at 2 inches, so down the center. Just like that. And then we're gonna fold it in and line those sides up. across and go down the other side. And then I'm gonna cut off the excess of my handles just to make them nice and flat across. So there's the edges, and there's my handle. I'm just gonna roll it up and set it aside. I won't need these until the bag is finished, which is why it's like, well, you may as well make them when you're ready to add them to your bag. But you're probably low on bobbin thread, you're gonna run out in the middle of top stitching, and it's like, ay, ay, ay. That, and I don't know about you, but by the time I get to that point in the bag, I'm tired, I wanna be done, and I'm less likely to take my time and make it a nice, neat top stitch. Even though it's like, really, it's just a straight stitch? Is that really that hard? Yes, yes it is. All right. And again, just gonna sew down one side. And if you have trouble sewing it nice and straight, they do have magnetic seam guides you can purchase. And then Gold Star Tool actually has edge feet that you can purchase if you have this sewing machine, which is the Juki DU1181N. So that's pretty cool. Okay. I mean, I thought I was gonna run out of bobbin thread, I guess not. Trimmed the edges, then we have another strap all done. If your strap looks, if you can kind of see the wrinkling there, that's pretty normal, especially for a vinyl this thin. This is leather-backed vinyl. So that's pretty normal to have that like wrinkling effect. Set it aside. I'm gonna wait to work on my crossbody strap until this bobbin has run out. Oh, I was looking for my crossbody strap. Seriously, it's sitting in front of my face. Yeah, I'm gonna wait until I run out of bobbin thread so I can change it. So, now we are going to work on the handle stripes, which are down here in this pile somewhere. Handle stripes. What are you? What are you? Are you the handle? Oh, this is the top of my lining. Get that out of the way. These are my handle stripes. So this is actually supposed to be two separate pieces. This is actually gonna be turned into four separate pieces. A handle stripe panel in half, wrong sides together and matching the two long edges, press to make a center crease. So essentially you're folding the raw edges in towards the center. I am using this vinyl, so I like to use my double-sided tape. I like to use a lot of double-sided tape. I think if somebody asked me to like sew a bag without double-sided tape, I would say no. And then I would just stop making bags. Just kidding. I'd figure it out somehow. Okay, so we're gonna fold the raw edges in towards the center. This is a 2-inch wide strip, so it ends up being a 1-inch wide strip. So you need 1-inch wide hardware. And if you can friggin' believe it, I sell 1-inch wide hardware on my website. So if you're looking, you're like, I want to make this bag. I need hardware. Like, I got you. Don't even worry about it. All right. What do you want me to do now? You should now have 4 handle stripes that are 1 inch wide and 9.5 inches long. Right, so I'm just folding it in half and cutting it. Fold 1 end of each handle stripe under 1/2 inch and press. And then we're gonna add a rectangle ring to that. Got it? Good. Folding these ends in. I'll also be adding a rivet because I don't want nothing to happen to these. Okay. I really, honestly, I don't like folding this in half to find the center and then cutting it because it's not super even. I don't know. Leaves a lot of room for error. Because we're human. Alright, so I have my 1-inch rectangles. These do have a welded seam, so I always like to make sure that that's under the handle connector. You don't have to, I'm just kind of a weirdo. Okay, I'm gonna cut these really long strips of double-sided tape now. I'm gonna put them on the back side where that seam is folded in. Fold this under. It says 1 inch. Okay. So they should now be like 8.5 inches or something. Or 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. They should be 8 inches tall. So what I did was I just peeled the tape back a little bit, secured that in place, and I'm gonna leave the tape on until I'm ready to use it again. So if I had to guess, I would say you need a 7-inch piece of double-sided tape if you want to measure it out and be fancy. You really, I don't want to say you never want it to be, but I don't like it when the tape touches the connectors. I used to be okay with it, but the connectors don't fly freely. They just kind of like stay in place and they're stuck to tape, so how can they? So that's my story and I'm sticking to it. 7-inch piece or smaller, whatever you want to do. It's like a Goldilocks situation where you don't want it to be too close, you don't want it to be too far, you want it to be just right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So I'm just folding these over until they're 8 inches tall. I'm not really worried about that whole 1-inch thing. I just want them to be the same height. And if I cut them wrong, which I may have, then I want to make sure they're all the same. Whoa. With you. That is at the 8 inches. Okay. Ah, I didn't catch it with the tape. Lauren, come on. It's okay. You can kind of restick, peel off, deal thing. Okay, 8 to the 16. There we go. And then I just kind of compare them, make sure they're all relatively the same height. Okay, so here is my main panel. My main panel is interfaced with woven fuse, Decoville light, and then a layer of foam. The pattern calls for fleece, but I really like the buoyancy that the foam adds. So again, my opinion, do what you want. And then we're gonna set this up 1 inch from the top and 1 inch from the side. It's gonna be kind of angled. I'm just gonna peel our tape off. I am using my little 1-inch ruler so that is set up perfectly. No issues. You see how I just kind of laid this along the side, set it down. Easy peasy lemon pie. I don't know. peasy lemon squeezy. Nailed it. So it's not quite an inch from the edge. There we go. I'm just gonna slide it up. Okay, that one is also just a little bit off. There we go. So these are gonna be kind of angled in to the side, and then we're going to sew those on. So let me just do all of them. That tape is holding them in place nicely. You okay, Ben? Okay. If you are new to my channel, then you might not have met Benjamin yet, but Benjamin is my cat who is literally sitting here sewing with me. Let's see if I can move him. That'd be okay. No? Anyway, sorry. Move the camera, but not the cat. He's here. It's fine. Ow! 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 He just clawed me. See, he's here. Ben, don't make me a liar. Anyway, we're putting on handle connectors. I forgot. You're allowed to get sidetracked. I'm just gonna slide this ruler up, tape it in place, and there we go. Okay. I did not plan for my kimono here to kind of go with the fabric, but it's happening, so let's just leave it at that. I'm gonna start at the bottom and backstitch and work my way up. I'm using a stitch length of 4.5. We're gonna go as close to the connector hardware as we can. We're gonna turn. I just do one little back stitch. Go forward slowly. You wanna make sure it lines up nicely. I'm gonna turn it around. I'm gonna grab just a little piece to put under there. Back stitch again. If I can, no, I can't. And then we're gonna head down. So there's that. And now what you can do, if you want to, you could sew another stitch across here, maybe a quarter of an inch from where you started. You could add a rivet, you could do a box stitch, but you want to make sure that you add a little more protection to that handle connector, or it's just gonna come undone. The stitching might come loose, and that would be bad news. I ran out of bobbin thread. I knew it was coming. Luckily, this is pretty forgiving thread, or fabric, I should say. Great timing. I'm going to take these stitches out because I don't want there to be like a weird line. So I'm just kind of pulling up, loosening it. Nailed it. Trim that off. And start again. Because who doesn't love doing the same thing twice? Me. And I'm stitching about 1/8 of an inch from the outer edge of that connector. happened? No. Looks like something happened with my bobbin thread. Maybe it's too tight. I didn't load it correctly. Something. Sometimes if your bobbin is too full, it'll act weird. So I think that might have been my issue. Let's try it again. It still doesn't sound happy. That's not good. What's wrong with you? Okay, well, the bobbin is still there. Sounds fine now. So when that happens, you just kind of go through the symptoms. What's wrong? How do I fix it? And we'll make a little mark for where we add the rivet. That one's definitely gonna need it. So we'll add our rivets and then we're going to make our crossbody strap. And I'm not going to show you guys how I install the rivets. If you are looking for a video that does show you, I have made one and it's, you know, it's available in my list of videos. But you'll need four rivets and four posts. I personally think rivets are a great way to add strength. They add a different look to the bag and they're just really nice. I love my rivets. I purchased my rivet press through Gold Star Tool. Great and affordable. The customer service is awesome. I've personally met David and he is really nice. Rivets are set. I know I said I was gonna do the crossbody strap next, and that's what I'm gonna do. Gotta commit. Don't say you're gonna do something and then don't do it. We don't like people like that. All right, so this leather-backed vinyl is a great vinyl to make crossbody straps with. It's not as thick as marine vinyl can get. It's definitely thinner than actual leather. And it lasts a pretty long time, actually. Flip her around. I don't know why I insist on flipping it around. I feel like the same thing could be achieved from the opposite, like just folding down, but I don't do it. It's not easy for me. Okay, so I always like to leave a little bit of a gap in between the layers to fold it over easily, but it doesn't always happen. All right, you guys ready? This is the best time to oil your machine. We got a fresh bobbin. Nothing can stop us. I hope. So for the crossbody strap, we need 2 snap hooks and 1 slide adjuster. These are the slide adjusters available through my website, and they do work awesome for vinyl straps, nice thick straps. I love them so much. So you want to kind of decide which way is the front, which way is the back. Right now I have the back facing up and the front of my slider is turned, so that I can see it. And then I leave that edge raw and just kind of backstitch forward. And then I make just a tiny little box. So 2 lines of stitching so that it's extra secure. Nothing's gonna happen. Because I've had this break on someone before and they emailed me and they were like, just wanted to let you know your products are awful, the bag broke. And I took it very hard, but you guys, you gotta learn from the criticism. Turn it into constructive criticism and figure out how you can make it better next time. All right, so slide one end through. I think I might do a video like showing exactly how to make a crossbody strap. I've done it before, but. And then keeping backside up, fold that through, fold that over. I'm gonna trim that. And I'm just using a lighter along the thread to melt the excess and keep it from fraying. I use bonded nylon. No, bonded polyester. Stop. And then I'm gonna sew a box stitch and add a rivet, I think. I think I'll add a rivet. Front access panels, I should say. nice little rivet. And there is our crossbody strap all finished. All right, so I'm just gonna set this aside. All right, it's accent panel time. So it shows what you should do if you're using woven accent panels. We are using non-woven accent panels. I'm gonna grab my basting spray real quick. Hopefully this is good to use. I just bought this from Hancock of Paducah. This is quilt basting spray, so I'm hoping it's pretty easy to use. We shall see. It's basically like hairspray. It has a bit of a smell to it, but it smells like all the other basting sprays I've used. Oh, it's got a really wide spray. I don't know that I'd recommend that. And you just want to line up your corners. There is one end of these side panels that has like, I would call this a roller coaster, and this is the bottom of the roller coaster. Okay, that feels like the 3M spray. I don't like this at all. I would say don't use it. No. I prefer Web Bond, but they don't sell it anymore. Sorry, you don't need to hear that. Wouldn't recommend this at all. Quilt basting spray by Sullivan's is a no from me for bag making. Okay. Line those up. Okay, so that's what those look like along the bottom. I love the way these look so much. They're so cute. Ugh. I'll get that off somehow. And you just want to sew 1/8 of an inch away from the outer edge. Go nice and slow. And then I am actually going to sew through the corner as well. Make your way back up. This prevents any kind of shifting that could happen. Keeps it nice and secure in place. Trim those excess threads. And then we'll do it again. 4 times. So this is actually the front panel where I'm going to be adding my magnetic snap. So this is the front of my bag because I really loved the flower placement there. It wasn't quite so obvious as this one. I don't know. I'm weird. You could even add 2 rows of stitching to that accent piece if you wanted. Make sure your threads don't get all wiggly-wommy in there. Missed my side panel. Okay, there we go. some people like to trim their excess threads kind of like while they're sewing their bag, and I like to do it at the end of a process just because it saves time. I don't know, is that weird? Maybe. Alright, so here's our front panel. What is up? What are we doing? We're gonna add the female snap. So the female snap is the one with the little dimple, circular opening. We're gonna grab our washer and our snap. I've already marked the placement, which is indicated on the pattern. I'm just gonna mark those parallel lines from the circle, stab, stab. This is a seam ripper by Tula Pink. I don't use it as a seam ripper. I literally only use it as a hole punch, basically. And then secure the washers along the back. And then I'm gonna add my nameplate wall here. I'm gonna add it kind of along the center of the bottom, like right there. Those holes. Perfect. So push it and open up those prongs. So there's my nameplate added as well. Perfect. All right, so now we are going to work on the top flap piece, and then we're gonna work on our lining, and then we're gonna get all of our exterior together, etc. It's gonna be awesome. So let's grab the male snap piece, and I had that marked out. Is it weird if I undo this? Kind of defeats the purpose, huh? All right, let me go grab my pattern piece and make sure, there we go. So in the center, make a little tiny snip. In the center, and it says 4.75 from the top. 1, 2, 3, 4. Got it. Okay. And this gets the male snap. Okay. Now, I don't really want to do this, but I'm going to be using this again, but I'm going to spray it over the trash can this time. Literally, I'm going to lay my piece in the trash can, give it a light mist, bring it back up, and lay this over top. So, why don't you just cut out two pattern pieces that are the same size? You have to trim this down anyway, so it doesn't make sense to line two pieces up absolutely perfect. So I just kind of trace it out and lay it over top, and then we're gonna sew along the outside edge, and then we're just gonna trim the excess. So it's like, why make it absolutely perfect the first time? You know what I'm saying? So stitch length is set to 4.5. I'm gonna follow around the outside edge with the edge of my foot. Go slow around those curves. Okay. now I'm gonna take my scissors and just, you wanna try and do this in as little scissor movements as possible. So don't like pick your scissors up, just kind of glide them around the curve. Okay. So there is the flap ready to go. If you used Decoville light in your flap on one side and then just a little extra reinforcement down here, it's gonna feel really nice. It's gonna have bend to it, but it's not gonna hold wrinkles. And it's just gonna last, I'm telling you. So now what we're gonna do is just, we're gonna test it out. Okay, so here is what that should look like. Let me just double check. Yes, so the way this sits is just kind of in between those connectors. Pretty nice, right? Okay, so we can set this aside. We're getting close. Good job, you're hanging in there. Yeah. I am going to work on my crossbody strap connectors now. I reinforced these with SF-101 because they're gonna hold a lot of weight. I need them to be strong. You know what I'm saying? So I'm using 1/2-inch D-rings. These are available from my website. They're really sturdy, really thick, and they do hold the swivel clips perfectly. So there's not gonna be a lot of sliding around, which is nice. And I'm going to cut this in half so that they're 1 inch wide and use some double-sided tape. I'm gonna use 1/4-inch just because 1/2-inch is kind of a lot. For it, such a tiny piece. And I'm actually going to sew these in my lining because the, you know, the, oh, okay then. Really, SF-101? You didn't fuse like at all? Even though I asked you to? I specifically asked you to? Fine. I'm joking. Luckily, this tape is kind of repositionable. Okay. Well, I lied about that. Is this side fused? This side's fused. Barely. Okay, fold the edges in. 1/2 inch is kind of small for a crossbody strap connector. I know what you're thinking, but that's why I made it. That's why I made it 1 inch wide. Like, that's why I interfaced it, I should say. Okay, so we're just gonna fold it in half and half and half. Gotta think about what I'm doing. Really, I just wanna put it in a seam, so I'm gonna clip this together. It's a little longer, but whatever. Then why did I think that would work? All right, let me make sure this is fused properly. I'm using waterproof canvas in my lining, so I don't need to add any extra interfacing. I will be adding 2 zippered pockets, so that's cool. Okay. Woven fused. I should have just used 1/2 inch. That was my bad. Don't listen to me. So I'm thinking what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna be sewing this on opposite sides of the lining in between these panels. And I'll explain what I mean in a minute. Let's get there first, shall we? Let's just get there. Okay, so I'll be adding two zippered pockets. So let's fold these in half. Open it up, and then this is another side. So here's a zipper pocket. Then I'm gonna fold this in half. And lay it on top. I'm adding an 8-inch zippered pocket and a 6-inch zippered pocket, or seven and eight. Don't ask me why, I just am. This is my zipper template from By Piera. These are amazing. I love that I don't have to think about it. Like, I just lay it down, mark it, and go. So this zipper is supposed to be an inch and a half from the top, and we're gonna eyeball it. Open. I'm using a khaki waterproof canvas, khaki colored from fwdfabrics.com. I believe the link is down below. So don't ask in the comments, just check the caption. No, I'm just kidding. You can ask in the comments. I don't mind. All right, and then we're gonna flip it through. So that way the pocket is on the lining side and then nothing is on the exterior. That didn't make sense, but anyway, I'm gonna iron this now. Pretend I didn't say that. Just pretend that I'm not an idiot. Cool? Cool. You can iron waterproof canvas. I definitely recommend using some steam. The steam will help kind of make it more pliable. Because waterproof canvas is really thick. Okay, so we're just gonna line that up. Why does this, oh, that's a 9-inch zipper? 10 to the 9, that's a 9-inch zipper. I meant to do 9. I didn't know. I didn't know. I'm sorry. I didn't know. All right. So I'm gonna hold on to my zipper pull and I'm gonna line it up inside the zipper pocket. And I just kind of start at the top middle. Top, near the top. Backstitch, backstitch. I'm using number 5 zipper tape because it's a nice pocket. Oh, they're just such nice zippers. They're a lot easier to sew through. Make sure you don't hit any of your metal zipper stops. That would be very bad. Okay. Since I'm using two zippered pockets that are different sizes. I'm gonna keep the bigger one open at the bottom. So I'm gonna lay this over top. And clip it in place. I'm going to trim my excess and fold the wrong side under so that the right side is out. So we're just going to fold this under like so. Yep, just like that. And iron it. And then we're going to see what the rest of the pattern says to do. Okay, so I'm gonna fold this in half. Make a little snip. Give a little snip snip. And always let your pattern be. I'm gonna grab my flap. Fold that into the center as well. Okay. And then we're gonna grab our top panel. And then it tapers at the top, so make sure you keep an eye on that. I've added a bunch of arrows pointing up so that I don't forget. But we wanna see this folded in half. So this is facing up. This is the top of my lining panel. This is facing up as well. You want to line up those snips. This is centered now. And we're going to baste that in place. So you should see your snap facing up. And then we're just going to baste it. Then we're gonna grab our lining panel and lay this over top. I didn't need to find the center of my lining panel, but if I can brag for a second, it matches up. It matches up good. All right, so now this is where I'm going to be adding my crossbody strap connector. Hopefully this works to the way I'm thinking I want it to. And I'm going to place it an inch, yes, 1 inch from the inside. I am going to leave all this extra stuff here hanging inside, if you can see it. Like, there's a lot of extra. I want it to be nice and close to my lining. And we're gonna sew using a 1/2 inch seam allowance and a smaller stitch length. Slip out? No, I did not. No, I did not. There we go. Back stitch. Okay. So now open and press the seam allowance toward the lining main panel. So It's going to be pointing down, which is exactly what I wanted. And we're going to sew through that. Decided if I want to add a rivet or not, but there is my crossbody strap connector. It's pretty close to the top of the bag, and then when you have weight in there, it's going to be holding it down. So the weight of the bag is holding itself down, and then it should work out. I've done this before. I'm going to sew through it towards the lining, actually. So I'm just going to add another little row of stitching into the lining. Ben, will you let go? Can I have that? Can you let go? Thank you. All right. And actually, you want to add it on the same side because then when they're facing each other, they're on opposite sides. So I'm glad we thought that through. Okay. Setting it aside. Get it out of here, we don't need it. This piece is folded in the center still. We're gonna open this baby up and fold this. So you wanna fold them in opposite directions, if I could go into detail further. So wrong side facing out, right side facing out, and then lay those on top, and the seams just meld them together. Hopefully that makes sense. So this is going to be my 7-inch zipper. So I just kind of ease on down. There's a 9, 8, 7, and trace it out. Make sure it's a nice flat surface. So two parallel lines. Alright, so now we're going to pull that through. And I iron from the front side because you cannot sew the back, or you cannot iron the back of waterproof canvas. Alright, so we'll grab our zipper. What size is that zipper? Oh, that's an 8-inch zipper. So I grabbed an 8 and a 9. Ugh, what a doofus. It's fine though. It's fine. Thank you. going to add the back side. I should have cut this as just one big pocket, but my brain wasn't working, obviously. So we're gonna sew around this in a square, not just, the U-shape I normally do. And when I first started making handbags, this was something I never really thought about, is that you can add more pockets and things than the pattern suggests. You know, these are just, basically outlines for you to start with to make your own, to make it your own, which is just really cool to me. I don't know. All right, so keep in mind which way is the top, which way is not. We're gonna lay that in place. Grab the clips that I just moved out of the way, absentmindedly. Half inch seam allowance. And then as I get close to the edge, I'm going to add my D-ring for my crossbody strap connector, 1 inch from the inside, or from that outside edge, I should say. And pretty close to the seam allowance. And then you're gonna fold this seam down and you're gonna stitch through the lining fabric, not the vinyl. And then I'm gonna sew a little further down. Just to kind of reinforce that D-ring. Okay? Okay? Cool? You following? Good, good, good. So now all that's left that's unsewn really is the bottom panels of the bag. And this part's fun. Guys, this part's real fun. Not really. Okay. I'm gonna start by sewing my side, my lining panels together. You want to line up the top stitch of your lining to start with, and then line up the bottom of your bag. And I'm going to be using a half inch seam allowance at the top, and then we're gonna go down a little bit wider of a seam allowance. So, back straight. Just a little bit. And then I'm not going to trim my excess seam allowance down because I want the bag to be a little thicker. I'm using fairly thin supplies, so no biggie. So since I'm sewing from the lining side, I'm gonna use a wider seam allowance to start. Taper it to a smaller one. And trim this extra off. Now that you're here, you can trim all your extra threads if you need to. There we go. So then when you open this up, you'll see your lining. And you'll see you've got crossbody strap connectors at opposite ends of the bag, which is good, because then when you've got it together, you know, it's like that. It's pretty cool. All right, so the bottom of my lining, I'm going to mark center snips in all four directions. So we'll fold it in half widthwise and lengthwise. We'll start by marking. I'm gonna fold open that side seam and line it up with the long ways snip. Open up that side seam, clip it to the sideways snip. And then if you can still see your center fold lines from where you added your zipper pocket, line it up with that. And I wouldn't say that the waterproof canvas holds wrinkles, but they're not gonna be gone that quickly, so. Yeah. And then I'll clip. Just add all kinds of clips. Ease in those corners. So there is the bottom of my bag all clipped on. And we're just gonna sew using a little bit wider than a half inch seam allowance. Again, this is gonna keep our lining from being saggy or too big. Inside, leave your needle down, I should say, and then resituate that way. Open up that side. And then I'm just trimming my extra seam allowance along the bottom, because you'll definitely feel that. Okay. So there is my bottom attached. Up and look down. Oh, there's what you see. Flip that aside. Now we're going to add our side panels on the bag. Alright, I'm going to start with the front. You want to line up the So here is our accent panel and here is our side accent panel. You want to line those up. They should be pretty even with each other. We'll just add clips, 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 and clips. If you've got a little overhang on the bottom, that's okay. It's going to work itself out, but those are pretty crucial to line up, in my opinion. All right, so we're gonna sew those at a half inch seam allowance, which is basically following along the outside line of the fleece. So small stitch length. And then you're gonna open it up and flip the panel open and press the seam allowance toward the side panel. Yeah, yeah. And top stitch along the seam. So here is our seam. It's gonna stay that way, and we're just gonna open this up and stitch along the side panel along the outside edge. Using a wider seam stitch length, so like 4.5, an eighth of an inch away from the edge. The part that gets a little hard to sew through is that side panel accent with all that fleece added. So just make sure you go slow. Okay, so there's that. And then we'll add the other. Where did I put it? Hello, where'd you go? Oh, it's sitting here. All right, make sure you don't sew it on upside down. That's why I say you want to line up those accent pieces to start with. Seam allowance. That stitch length is small again. The very first time I made this bag, I was not paying attention closely enough to the seam allowances, and it didn't work out very well. So make sure you guys keep that in mind as you're sewing. The seam allowances for this bag are very, very important. Okay, top stitch, eighth of an inch away. And I always like to start by top stitching the front of the bag, because it's going to be like basically a big tube, and it gets hard to top stitch the very last piece. So keep that in mind. Okay, lining up those side panels. That's okay, because now I know when I start to top stitch this bag, I've got a full bobbin. That's gonna feel good. That is one thing I hate about really thick thread, is your bobbins aren't quite as full, even though they're bigger than a regular machine at this point. So when I used to use really crappy thread, I was able to make my bobbins last a really long time, but the thread wasn't that great, so the bags didn't last a really long time. All right, bobbin, that was a really nice place of you to run out of thread. I'm not going there. I was able to hide that a little bit. All right, so now we're going to match up the last edges. So this part is where it gets complicated, and there's really just want to pull your hands along as you go. There we go. One hand inside is nice. One hand on the outside. Sure, your needle is up pretty high. You don't want to hurt your bag, cut anything. Trim those excess threads, and now we are ready to add the bottom of the bag. Alright, bag bottom, where'd you go? Fell on the floor. Every video, man. My videos should be sponsored by the floor, because I mention the floor a lot. Anyway. So the pattern has these really awesome notches along the bottom that tell you like where the side panel should go. So I always just start with those notches and everything else should kind of work itself out. And the notch should be on the outside edge. So our lining centers mesh. They match. It's pretty awesome. And then our sides. You're just gonna kind of lay it in place, kind of pinch it around, and it should fit nice and snug. And I will be using my stapler. I believe you have my stapler. My little stapler, to keep those curves in place while I sew. So those clips are nice, but they tend to move, so I just add staples in those curves once I get it all lined up. Running out of staples definitely happens. This is a tiny stapler. There we go. I'd say you don't need more than like 6 to 8 per side. So like 3 per corner. If you want to staple the whole bottom of the bag, that's you can do that, I guess, but I don't. You want to staple within like 1/8 of an inch seam allowance from the edge, maybe 1/4 of an inch, because you have that 1/2 inch seam allowance. Okay. So, hopefully you can see where I've added some staples, especially along that corner. I'm going to start in the center of the bag. My stitch length is going to be at a 3.5. And we're gonna follow the outline of the Peltex or Decoville Light, whichever you decided to use. sometimes I'll put my hand inside the bag at the curve just to kind of make sure my fabric isn't puckering. And then I'm going to trim my excess seam allowance. Bottom of the bag feels nice. If you need to be careful removing those staples, use a staple remover. And now I'm going to add purse feet. Purse feet really help the bag, stay clean. It makes the life of your bag a little longer. I'm gonna be using 5 of them today. 2, 3, 4, and 5. So the bottom of the bag at this moment is 1, 2, 3, 4 and a half wide. So 2.25 is my center. 1, 2, 2.25. There is my center. And I'll make a hole. Since I'm adding 5 purse feet, the center mark, is where one will go, and then we'll add 2 in opposite directions, kind of like on a dice. Kind of add them an inch and a half from the outside edge. Inch and a half from the outside edge. Is that an inch and a half? What are you? Oh, that's 1 inch from the outside edge. And 2.5 inches in. So 2.5 inches in. It's right about here. 1 inch from the outside edge is there. And then I'm gonna line my other one up with that so that it's 1 inch from the outside edge. Boom, nailed it. Didn't make much sense. Sounded like nonsense, but whatever. Are punched, and then make sure you don't install your purse feet the wrong way, if you know what I mean. If you have trouble fusing Peltex or Decaville to your vinyl, Purse feet are also a really great way to keep that in place. When I first started making handbags, I had the hardest time fusing vinyl with Peltex, and so purse feet were a great way to make up for that, basically. I sell purse feet through my website, and they come with washers. If your purse feet don't come with washers, you need to ask the company why they think it's cool for purse feet to just fall out of bags. But you can also use duct tape. I feel like there's another kind of tape that's been recommended. If you know it, feel free to comment down below. Let us know how you keep your purse feet in place. Purse feet attached. And now we're ready to add the lining. All right. So for this part, you want to make sure that your flap is on the opposite side of the bag. Okay? You hear me? You know what I'm saying? Make sure the side zippers are unzipped. With the exterior right side out. I'm not doing that. We put our exteriors wrong side out, our linings right side out. Because your lining is smaller. So flap is on the opposite side, flap is facing towards the back because when you undo your bag, the flap comes forward. And one way to help you with your side seams is to fold your side panel in half and make a center snip. Match up those side panels and make a center snip within that accent fabric, and that's where you're gonna line up the side of your lining. Perfect fit! Yay! Just kind of push, pull, whatever you gotta do, manipulate. Yeah, I pull it. Clipping from the right side out. If you've reached this point and things don't line up, if your lining is kind of puckering, then your exterior is too big and you need to start over. If your exterior is kind of puckering, then your lining is too big, right? I don't know, I'm too tired. Ugh, I was outside today and I got like bug bites. That's not nice, that's why I don't go outside. Another tip, just avoid going outside and people if you can. Okay, so I'm gonna start in the center because the foam or fleece, whatever you decided to use, kind of dictates that half inch seam allowance. We've got a small stitch length. And we're just gonna sew and move around and go slow. Thank you. trim any excess threads we've got laying around. Gather up all those clips again, because I'm going to need them to top stitch the bag. Where's my... Alright, so now we are going to birth our bag. Pull out your lining first. This is going to be a workout. If you're able to, leave a 9-inch opening. You'll thank me later. Start with the bottom of the bag. I kind of fold it like a taco and pull it through that pocket. Why I kind of work it out in a circular motion. I doubt it actually helps. So now we're going to push our exterior out. There we go. Just kind of work out that seam around the bottom. Kind of massage it open if you can. Looks pretty good. Another thing I like to do is shove my lining in the bag before I sew it closed. Just as another precaution. Beautiful. I did not trim my excess seam allowance along the top. I like the firm feeling of that seam. I think it gives the bag a nice quality. Stitch. And just kind of roll the seam along your fingers so that it's nice and straight. This seam here, you're actually going to be sewing through the top of the flap. So what I'm gonna do is I'm going to use a little piece of 1/4 inch double-sided tape to hold it in place. So I'm gonna put the tape down here. Well, let me double check the instructions. I'm like 99% sure that's what I'm supposed to do. But I haven't made this bag in a while, so let's just be 100%, shall we? That'd be a good idea. You should be sewing through the closure flap. Thought so. Okay. We're gonna peel that open. And now it will stay in place. Ta-da! I'm still gonna add clips though, because I don't want that seam to be all weird. I want it to be like all weird. All right, so here is what our bag looks like. This is where the flap is gonna lay down nice and pretty. She's gorgeous. I like it very much. I'm gonna sew my opened pocket shut. I always like to do this before top stitching the top of the bag. One, first reason I should say, is because your stitch length is already set pretty small. Second, once you add those handles on, you're gonna be like, oh, it's done, yay! And you're not even going to be thinking about the fact that you left that pocket open. Cool beans. And then we can stick that pocket inside the bag. I really like this khaki for the lining. I was going to use something like dark gray. I just thought it wouldn't look nice, so glad I did what I did. I regret nothing. Stick that back in, resituate the lining, and now we're ready to top stitch. Woo! Okay. I'm gonna start over here. I'm gonna switch to a 4.5. That's been our consistent top stitch length of this bag. Broke a clip. Next stitch, and just go nice and slow. Make sure you don't hit any hardware, any zippers along the way. And when you resituate, leave your needle in. Stitching is completed. So for the very last time, resituate that lining back in there. And now you can snap it closed and admire what you've done. Guys, that looks so good. I'm excited. So now we are going to add our handles, which are done and in this box. Normally I would add strap ends, but I have a feeling this person isn't going to really appreciate them, just because they are a little bit bulky. So I am just going to rivet the straps on and call it a day. But I will show you guys what it looks like with the crossbody in there as well. Another way you can wear this bag crossbody is just putting it on alternate strap connectors. So you can put one here and one here instead of having a separate inside piece. But I think it's gonna look pretty nice inside of there. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. We did good. We did real good. So that's what it looks like inside. I don't know that I would heavily recommend this bag as a crossbody bag alone because it is such a stylish shape, but it's cute. Looks good. Alright you guys, that is it for this video. Thank you so much for watching. If you liked what you saw, feel free to subscribe, check out my other videos, and leave a comment below if you would definitely be making this bag. Thanks, bye guys!